Hello everybody, today we are going to see some problems which are depend on the concept volume of sphere. Okay, so see here, our first problem is a solid is in the form of cylinder, a solid is in the form of cylinder with hemispherical ends. The total height of the solid is 19 cm and the diameter of the cylinder is 7 cm. Find the volume and surface area of the solid. Two things we here we need to find out. What is given first sentence, a solid is in the form of cylinder with hemispherical ends. So we will see here figure, a solid is in the form of cylinder with hemispherical ends. Okay, it is in the form of cylinder with hemispherical ends. Okay. Means figure we will get like this. So, okay. Now what is given? The total height of the solid is 19 cm. Total height of the solid. This is 19 cm. And the diameter of the cylinder is 7 cm. Diameter of the cylinder is 7 cm. This is 7 cm. Find the volume and surface area of the solid. Find the volume, volume also we have to find out, and surface area. Surface area means total surface area of this figure. Okay. So first we will think here this diameter of the cylinder is given 7 cm. So definitely radius will be 7 by 2, that is 3.5 cm. So radius of this cylinder or diameter of cylinder and diameter of hemisphere will be same. Okay, so we can consider same radius for all the three figures. Okay, cylinder and two hemispheres are there. Okay, so first question they are asking, find the volume. First, if I want to find out volume of this whole solid, then what we will do? We will find out volume of cylinder plus volume of this hemisphere. Okay, these are two identical ends. So we can find out volume of this hemisphere and we can multiply by 2 or we can add 2 times. Understood? So here we will find out first volume of cylinder. Okay, volume of cylinder is equals to pi r square h. So that formula we will use. So what is given here? See, radius of cylinder, radius of cylinder, that is we will consider r, that is 7 by 2, that is 3.5 cm or 7 by 2 also we can use. Okay, so that is radius. Now we need to think about height, but height, whole height is given, whole height is given. Understood? Means height of whole solid is given. Okay, so here we need to think, this is 7 cm, this diameter is 7 cm, so radius will be 3.5, radius will be 3.5 cm. Okay, so this distance also is equals to the radius, this distance is also equals to the radius. Okay, so we need to subtract from 19, this is whole height, from this whole height we need to subtract this side radius, that is 3.5, and downside 3.5. okay, so 7 cm we will subtract from 19, that will be the height of the cylinder. Okay, so h is equals to height of cylinder is equals to 19 minus 3.5 plus 3.5 cm. So 19 minus 3.5 plus 3.5, it will be 7, so it will be 12 cm. So height of the cylinder is 12 cm. Okay, now we have radius, we have height, we can find out volume of cylinder. So volume of cylinder is equals to, volume of cylinder is equals to pi r square h. So it will be 22 by 7, pi is 22 by 7, radius is 3.5. So directly you can take 7 by 2 also, because we can cancel 7. So 7 by 2 into 7 by 2 into 12 centimeter cube. So that will be volume of cylinder. So here we can cancel 7, 2, 11 are, 2, 6 are. Okay. So what is remaining here? 11, 7 are 77, 77 multiply by 6, okay, 77 multiply by 6 centimeter cube. So 462 cm³. 462 centimeter cube is the volume of cylindrical part, okay, middle part. Now what we will do, we will find out volume of hemisphere, okay. So what is the formula of volume of hemisphere? We use 2/3 πr³. Understood? From that radius is r, that is known as 3.5 centimeter, that is given. So radius of all the three figures is same, so we will use the same radius for that also. So volume of hemispherical end is equal to 2/3 πr³. So it will be 2/3 × 22/7 multiplied by radius. What is radius? 3.5. So we can use there 7/2 × 7/2 × 7/2. Okay. So here we can cancel these 7, 7, 2, 2 will be cancelled. 2 11s are 22. So what is remaining here again? 11 7s are 77. 77 multiplied by 7. So 77 multiplied by 7 divided by 3 2s are 6. Okay. So here this product will be 539/6 cm³. 539/6 cm³. Okay. So this is the volume of a hemispherical end. Like that, two ends are there identically. So we need to add this also. Okay. So what is first question they have? They are asking us find the volume. Okay. So total volume is equals to the volume of cylindrical part, that is 462 plus volume of both the ends. So 539/6 plus 539/6 into cm³. Okay. So we need to do addition of this. So first 539 we can multiply here. So here it will be this, we can write 539 plus 462 plus 539. Here denominator is same, denominators are same, so we can add 1078, okay, divided by 6. So 462 multiplied by 7 will be 2772 plus 1078/6. So you will get this addition, 3850 divided by 6. 3850 divided by 6. So we can find out this answer. 6, it will be 6 6 are 36, then 4 will come 1.67 cm³. Okay, so this is the volume of whole figure. Understood? So here half answer over, find the volume. So volume, you got volume of cylindrical part plus volume of hemispherical end, it is identical, so we can multiply by 2 or we can add the same answer twice, two times. Okay, so finally you will get volume of this whole figure. Now after that question they are asking surface area of the solid. We are going to find out now surface area. Okay, same thing, surface area of cylindrical part plus surface area of hemisphere, again we need to add the same surface area, or we can multiply here by 2 and then we can add. Okay, so again I am doing here radius is 7/2, that is 3.5 cm. okay, height is 12 cm, we are thinking about cylinder. Okay, so surface area, curved surface CSA of cylinder is equals to 2πrh. Okay, 2πrh. So what we will do here, 2 multiplied by 22 by 7 multiply by radius is 7/2 into height is 12. Okay, so here we can cancel this 2 2, 7 7 will be cancelled. So 12 2s are 24, again 12 2s are 24 plus 2, 26, 264 centimeter square. This is the area of cylindrical part. Okay. Now we will do, we will find out area of this hemisphere, curved surface area of hemisphere. Okay. So now here we will use CSA of hemisphere. CSA of hemisphere is equal to 2 pi r square. Okay. Multiply by 2. This will come. So afterwards we will multiply, that is 2 multiply by 22 by 7 multiply by radius of this is 7 by 2. So 7 upon 2 into 7 upon 2. Okay. Again the same thing, we can cancel these 2. 2 11s are, this 7 7 will be cancelled. So what is remaining? 11 7s are 77 centimeter square. So this is the curved surface area of a hemispherical end. Like that, two ends are there. So we will multiply total CSA of both ends is equal to 77 multiply by 2 centimeter square. So 154 centimeter square. Okay, 154 centimeter square. So we can add this, both the this curved surface area of cylinder plus curved surface area both hemispherical ends. So total TSA, total CS curved surface area is equals to 264 plus 154 centimeter square. Okay, so 4 plus 4 418 centimeter square. So that will be the curved surface area which they are asking. Total surface area of the solid. So surface area of the solid is 418 centimeter square. Okay. Okay. So our second problem is, a solid toy is in the form of right circular cylinder with hemispherical shape at one end and a cone at the other end. Their common diameter is 4.2 centimeter and the height of the cylindrical and conical portions are 12 centimeter and 7 centimeter respectively. Find the volume of the solid toy. Okay, this is given question. Okay, so now we will try to make here figure according to the given information. What is given? See, first sentence, a solid toy is in the form of right circular cylinder with hemispherical shape at one end and a cone at the other end. Okay, so here if we will try to make here figure, then what is given? Middle shape is cylindrical. Okay, in the form of right circular cylinder with hemispherical shape at one end, hemispherical shape at one end and cone at another end. Okay, so you will get like that figure. Now what is given? Their common diameter is 4.2 centimeter. Okay, common diameter means diameter of this cone also, cylinder also and hemisphere, that is 4.2 centimeter. Okay, so radius of all the three figures you will get same. Now, and the height of the cylindrical and conical portions are 12 centimeter and 7 centimeter respectively. Okay, cylindrical and conical portion. So height of cylinder that is 12 centimeter and height of cone, conical portion means height of cone is 7 centimeter. Okay, height of hemispherical end is not given, so that we can find out easily. So 12 centimeter and 7 centimeter respectively, find the volume of the solid toy. Okay, here we are going to find out volume of this solid toy. Okay, so very simple question, there are three solid figures. First we will find out volume of cylinder, okay, plus volume of cone and then volume of hemispherical end. Okay, so for that we must know radius and height. Okay, here height is given. What is the formula to find out volume of cylinder? Pi r square h. From that radius is given, we can find out radius from this diameter and height is given. So easily we can find out volume of cylinder. Second thing, volume of cone is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, so height is given, radius is given. So that also we can find out easily. Here volume of hemisphere. What is volume of hemisphere we use? 2 by 3 pi r cube. Here radius is not given. So here we need to decide radius. Okay. So diameter is 4.2. So definitely its radius. Radius will be half of 4.2, that is 2.1. Okay. So height of the height of this is, or radius we can say 4.2 divided by 2. 4.2 divided by 2, that is 2.1, or 21 by 10 also we can write. Okay, so all the things are available now. Now we can find out very easily its volume. Okay, so first I am going to find out volume of cylinder. Okay, so middle part, volume of, to find out volume of cylinder, radius of cylinder we will say R1. Okay, R1 we will use, that is 4.2 divided by 2, that is 2.1, or R also we can say, because radius is same for all the three figures. So 2.1 we can write 21 by 10 also if necessary. Then height of the cylinder, so height we will take, height of the cylinder, that we will say H1. Okay, because heights are different. Height is 12 centimeter, height of cone is 7 centimeter. So H1 is 12 centimeter. Okay, so now we will find out volume of cylindrical part. Cylindrical part. Okay, so which formula we use for volume? Pi r square into h. Okay, so that I am keeping as it is. Now second thing, volume of cone. Okay, so this is our first thing. Now we will think about volume of cone. So height of cone we will say h2. Height is given 7 centimeter. Okay, and radius is 4.2 means divided by 2 means 2.1 centimeter. Okay, so this is second thing. So what is volume of cone is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square into h2 we will see, 1 by 3 pi r square h2. Okay, because height is different. So now this is second formula. Now third one is volume of hemispherical end. Okay, which formula we use? 2 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, so radius is 2.1. okay, radius of this is 2.1, so radius I will mention here, radius is equal to 2.1 centimeter. Okay, so formula we use, 2 by 3 pi r cube, so equals to 2 by 3 into pi into r cube. This is only formula directly we can use. Okay, so now we are going to find out total volume of the solid toy. So total volume of solid toy is equals to volume of cylindrical part plus volume of conical part plus volume of hemispherical part. Okay, so all the three volumes we need to add here. So first one is pi r square h. Volume of cylindrical part is pi r square h1. H1 we will see here. Okay, pi r square h1. So this is h1. Now second, volume of cone, 1 by 3 pi r square h2 plus 2 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, so this is the total volume of the solid toy. Okay, so now we can remove common factor from this. So what is here? Pi r square is the common factor here also available, in second term also available, and in third term pi r cube is there, so one r is going to remain inside. Okay, so that I am taking outside. So pi r square, what is going to remain from this? h1 plus, from this what is going to remain? h2, 1 by 3 into h2, 1 by 3 into h2 plus, from this 2 by 3 into r,
okay, because r square we have taken outside, here r cube is there, so 1 r is going to remain in bracket. Okay, so finally we can put here values, that is pi is 22 by 7, radius is common, that is 2.1, so 2.1 I can write 21 by 10 into 21 by 10, because r square is there. H1 we have taken height of cylinder, that is 12 centimeter plus 1 by 3 into H2 is the height we have taken for cone, so that I am taking now here 7 centimeter plus 2 by 3 into radius is common, that is 21 by 10. Okay, 2.1 we can write 21 by 10. Now we need to do this calculation, so here we can write 7, 3s are 21. Okay, so here what is remaining, here we can take 2 5s are 10, 11, then here also we can take, okay, so here 11 3s are 33 multiply by 21 upon 50, 11 3s are 33 into 21 upon 50 into here 12 plus 1 by 3 means here what is going to come, 12 plus 7 by 3 plus here we can do 2 5s are 10 and 3 7s are 21. Okay, so what is remaining here, 7 by 5. Okay, so again here we need to make denominator same, into here 12 by 1. Okay, so here you will consider here, so we can make here 5 3 is a 15, 15 is the LCM, so we need to convert 1 multiply by 15. Okay, we are making here, sir, 15,
33 into 21 upon 50 multiply by 180 plus 35 plus 21 divided by 15. So now we can do here, see, 33 multiply by 21 into this sum is 5 plus 1 6, then 2 plus 3 plus 2 5 plus 8 is 33, and this is 236 divided by 50 into 50. Okay, here we can take lowest term, that is 25, here 2 1s are 2, then 18, okay, 118. Here also we can do 3 5s are 15, 3 11s are, okay. So now what is remaining here, 11 into 21 multiplied by 118 divided by 5 into 25. Okay, so here again 11 into 21, this product will come 27,258 divided by 125. 27,258 divided by 125 upon 125, so finally answer is 218.064 centimeter cube. So that is the volume, required answer is this. Okay, only we need to do here calculations. Okay,
our third problem is a cylindrical tub of radius 5 centimeter and length 9.8 centimeter full of water. A solid is in the form of a right circular cone mounted on a hemisphere is immersed into the tub. If the radius of the hemisphere is 3.5 centimeter and height of the cone outside the hemisphere is 5 centimeter, find the volume of water left into the tub. Okay, value of pi is given 22 by 7. Okay, so here first we will try to make figure according to the given information. What is the first sentence? See, a cylindrical tub of radius 5 centimeter. There is a cylindrical tub of radius 5 centimeter. Radius is given 5 centimeter and a length 9.8 centimeter. Length means here we will consider that is the height of the cylinder, 9.8 centimeter. Okay, it is full of water, it contains water. Okay, now so first thing here we need to find out volume of this. Okay, for to find out volume of cylinder we use pi r square h and all the things are available, so we can find out easily volume of the cylinder. Now what is given? See, second, a solid is in the form of right circular cone mounted on a hemisphere. A solid is in the form of right circular cone mounted on a hemisphere is immersed into the tub. Okay, like that. Right circular cone mounted on a hemisphere. Mounted on a hemisphere is immersed into that. Okay, into the tub. If the radius of the hemisphere is 3.5, radius of the hemisphere is given 3.5. This is given 3.5 centimeter. And height of the cone outside the hemisphere is 5 centimeter. Height of the cone is given. This height of the cone is 5 centimeter. Height of the cone is given 5 centimeter. Find the volume of water left into the tub. Okay, find the volume of water left into the tub. Okay, so first we will think how to solve this problem. Okay, so first, as I told you, we need to find out volume of cylinder. Okay, volume of cylinder we can find out because radius is given, height is given. So we can find out volume of cylinder very easily. Then we need to find out volume of this solid. Okay, means hemisphere plus cone, right circular cone. Okay, so hemisphere, volume of hemisphere is equal to 2 by 3 pi r cube, and radius is given 3.5 centimeter. So that also we can find out very easily. Then secondly, we need to find out volume of cone. Volume of cone is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, so height is given 5 centimeter, and radius means as radius will be as same as sphere, so that is 3.5 centimeter. So that values, those values we can put, and we will get the volume of solid which is immersed into the tub. Okay, so finally, after that, when we will get both the volumes, volume of cylinder and volume of solid, okay, that time we have to subtract volume of solid from the volume of cylinder. So that will be our required answer. Okay, so we will start now. First, we will find out volume of cylinder. Okay, so to find out volume of cylinder, radius of cylinder is equals to, what is given, radius of cylinder 5 centimeter. Okay, so that we will consider r 5 centimeter, and then height of the cylinder we will take h is equal to, height of the cylinder is 9.8 centimeter. Okay, then we will find out volume of cylinder is equals to, volume of cylinder is equals to pi r square into h. So pi is 22 by 7, radius is 5 centimeters, so 5 multiplied by 5 into h. H is equal to 9.8 centimeter cube. Okay, so 9.8 is divisible by 7, so we can do here, we can, 7 ones are 7, 7 fours are, so 14, 1.4. okay, so what is remaining here? 22 into 5, 110, 110 into 5, 550 multiply by 1.4 centimeter cube. Okay, so here 770 centimeter cube, 770 centimeter cube is the volume of cylinder, okay, which contains water, means volume of water. Okay, so that is 770. So here half answer over. Now we need to find out volume of cone plus volume of sphere. Okay, so volume of cone, right circular cone, plus volume of hemisphere. Okay, volume of cone is equals to, what is volume of cone? 1 by 3 pi r square h, okay, plus 2 by 3 into pi r cube. Okay, so directly we can find out, otherwise radius we get, height is different, radius and pi we can take outside, and that way also we can solve. Okay, so anyhow we can do this. This is, I am taking this pi is common, radius of cone, and this is same, so radius and this is pi r square we can take outside, 1 by 3 pi r square we can take outside, so that I am taking here 1 by 3 into pi r square. Okay, what is remaining here? H plus here 2 into R. H plus 2R. Okay, so now here 1 by 3 into pi is 22 by 7. Okay, radius is, radius of this is 3.5. 3.5 means we can write 7 by 2 into 7 by 2 into height. Okay, height, whose height? Cylinder, sorry, cone. Volume of, height of cone is 5 centimeters. So 5 we will take here plus 2 times radius. 2 times radius means 2 into 3.5 or 7 by 2. 2 will be cancelled anyhow. Okay, so now here we can do here 7. 7 will be cancelled. 2 11s are 3, 22 by 7, 7 by 2 into 7, 7 will be cancelled. Here remain 11 7s are 77. 77 upon 3 2s are 6. Multiply by 3.5 into 2, 7. 7 plus 5, it will be 12. So 6 1s are 6, 6 2s are 12. So here it is remaining 154 centimeter cube. This is the volume of this solid, which is immersed into the cylinder. Okay, now one more step we need to do, that is volume of this, volume of cylinder minus volume of solid, then that will be the required answer. Okay, so volume of cylinder, that is 770 centimeter cube minus volume of solid, that is 154 centimeter cube. Okay, so that is, this is 616 centimeter cube. So this is the required answer. Okay, so first see once again what we have done. This is radius of cylinder was given, height of cylinder was given with the help of volume of cylinder. Okay, which contains water, means volume of water, then volume of cone and volume of hemisphere. Solid contains hemisphere and cone both. So we can find out separately also, or we can take common factor and then also we can solve. So we got that is 154 centimeter cube. Okay, so finally from this volume we need to subtract this, so it will be 616 centimeter cube. Okay, thank you.